In 2021, the government launched free internet services in Kampala under the third phase of national data transmission backbone infrastructure. This was expanded in 2022 when government increased Wi-Fi hotspot program to cover 2,000 sites across the country. However, as government seeks to borrow more money to expand internet connectivity across the country and expand the Wi-Fi hotspots, members of parliament on the Committee of Physical Infrastructure asked what happened to the existing Wi-Fi hotspots.
When somebody was talking about Wi-Fi, I just couldn't understand it, Chair. We have even cried about Wi-Fi. Even this parliament here, it's Wi-Fi, it can't be reliable. Now you are telling me Wi-Fi will be spread in those other places before even work on this one that has existed for generations.
You cannot show that they are working with the Ministry of Energy on whether there's power in some of the areas where they intend. So there's absolutely no coordination. The whole lawn is in disarray.
Dr. Atweeb Mogasa, the executive director of the National Information Technology Authority, Uganda, told the legislators that the Wi-Fi, which was rolled out in 2021, was implemented before Uganda adopted the advanced technology, and its performance has not been so effective.
The Wi-Fi 6 that we are rolling out, we have already rolled out at the airport, but we intend to roll out in all other locations where we have Wi-Fi.
We should be provided with the list of where these hotspots are going to be.
In the new proposal, government seeks to borrow up to 1.05 billion yuan, approximately 562 billion shillings, from the Exim Bank of China to finance the supply, installation, commissioning and support phase 5 of the national data transmission backbone infrastructure.
Authorize my ministry in line with the requirements of Article 159 of the Constitution to borrow up to 1.05 billion, remove special drawing rights from the Export-Import Bank of China.
Appearing before the Committee of National Economy to justify the proposal to borrow, the ICT Minister, Dr. Chris Waliomunsi, directed NITAU to shift the current Wi-Fi hotspots to schools, health facilities and other government facilities or create new ones in order to make an impact on the public.
They have to create these hotspots, they also put them in the areas. I'm sure like students will benefit more. People in the Murago Hospital, and other universities and other areas.
So I think should be able to serve so that we are able to differentiate which funding is handling which hotspot. Yeah? If
committee members questioned the return on government investment into expansion of internet, wondering whether value for money has been realized.
Let us with the matrix on all the districts in the country and what every district is getting out of these three phases. So that would give us a clear analysis of what is going on.
Legislators also expressed concerns that NITAU, which is meant to implement the project, has been lined up for merger in the ongoing process of rationalization of government agencies.
I want the ministers to address us on how this project will run in the event NITAU disappears.
Under the project, 3,604 kilometers of backbone network and 51 backbone transmission sites are to be implemented to increase coverage of the backbone, with 56 new areas that will see internet coverage increase to 83%. This loan will also cover the last mile connection of 2,204.